Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this session, I'm going to discuss about field parameters in Power BI. This is very interesting and fantastic future in terms like it really enables the self-servicing business intelligence. Why I'm saying that self-servicing business intelligence, you will understand it at the end. In this video, the main agenda is to understand what is the existing problem with the Power BI environment and how this field parameters helps to solve that issue. That's the main focus of this video. Let's try to understand what this field parameter is. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So the field parameters definition says it allows users to dynamically change the measures or dimensions being analyzed within a report. So basically, as a business user, he is seeing a report by location of how much sales it has happened. Instead of location, he wants to see the report differently, like by product type. He can't do it right now. That is the main problem. So as the definition says, users to dynamically change the measures or dimensions. So till now, whether users can't change the dynamically measures or dimensions, the answer is yes. There are some workarounds or some tricky methods we used to change, make it work, to change the dynamic measures or dynamic dimensions. But there is no straightforward way from Microsoft. So users are supposed to see whatever has been developed in Power BI Desktop or whatever been edited in the Power BI services. The business users sees only those things. He cannot able to change the measures or dimensions. So this field parameters now enables the users to change measures or dimensions. That's what it is trying to solve. If you are still puzzled what I am trying to convey, what is the existing issue, let's jump into a demo and you will understand it much better. So we are in Power BI service now. So this is how usually people will able to consume or business user can see the report. I have edit access, so that's why I get it. But otherwise some pro users who have only view access will not have edit options as well. So now this is the report. First, we will see how this report works, right? This report based on a filter, that is Bangalore, Chennai, different locations, how much sales has happened. If the user interested to click on Bangalore, then it will be filtered by Bangalore and Chennai, something like that. So there is some kind of interactivity between the charts, because when you click on this, then you can see all the charts are filtered by 2019. This is fine with self-servicing BI. I mean, the users can able to analyze by themselves. But if user wants to see the split of each location, right? This is not possible here, because this location is provided as the filter dimension here. I mean, filter, that is a slicer here, right? So only user has to choose as a slices. He cannot see it in this location wise, or otherwise instead of category, he wants to see by another category or color, right? The color is not part of this hierarchy also. So I mean, here you have hierarchy. He wants to see by color. He cannot change between the dimensions of the same chart. This chart is fixed for the product hierarchy. You see, one is item category, and you can drill down, you can see the item amount. You cannot have any other dimensionality in this particular chart. So the characteristics of this charts are predefined. Only these two items are the dimensions, only category and item can be viewed in this chart. And the amount is fixed, I mean the measure is fixed. Sales amount. What happens if the user wants to change this chart dynamically? He wants to see it by color. He wants to see it by location. That is not currently possible. This is the issue we are currently having. This is what field parameters trying to solve. Nevertheless, it is not only the dimension, it is applicable to measure. Now user sees category by total soils amount. He wants to see category by quantity. He can dynamically switch between these two, either by dimension or by measure. That is what field parameters trying to solve. Let's try to understand how it works. So I am having this simple chart here, and as I said before, we cannot change it dynamically here, item category name and item name right now. But when you go to modeling and you see option called fields, okay, if you do not see this, I think you need to enable in the options menu. Go to options and settings, it is in the preview feature. So go to options, then use the preview feature, enable the checkbox, this checkbox, and then you need to restart it, then it will start appearing for you. So go to modeling tab and click on new parameter fields. Okay, this is for what if parameter that we have a separate video, and this is for field parameter. When you click on fields, let's first dynamically create dynamic dimension. Okay, dynamic dimension, then you can drag and drop what are the dynamic columns you want to choose here. Okay, I want category name, I want a parent brand name, and also I want by location. Okay, that's it. So by using these three, I want to dynamically change this chart. Okay, so there was a checkbox while creating that parameter, create a slicer for that the field parameter. So it started appearing. Let me maximize some size for this slicer header. Let us try to increase it. Then values, let us try to increase it. That's okay. I hope now it's visible. Now here, once you choose it, nothing will happen because only the slicer we have used. In this chart also, we need to use the same column, this dynamic column. So once you choose it, now you see it is showing by category name. Once you change the parent brand, now you can see this chart is changing accordingly. Parent brand, location. See, as I said before in the previous example, there is nowhere in this chart and this report people can change between the location. It can be acting as a slicer, but I cannot change this chart with different dimensionality. Right, the dimension remains same. It is by product category and product name, or that is category name. When you drill down, it is item, that is product. But I cannot change this chart by location. Now this field parameter enables me to change with different dimension. I can change by location, I can change by parent brand or category name, whatever I wish to. So this is the simple configuration you need to do. Just you go to modeling, just choose fields, then select the fields you want. This is the checkbox that automatically created a slicer. Then use this slicer from this slicer as well as in your chart. These two should use the same column, that is this newly created column. Then your chart will work. So this is for changing the different dimensionality. What about my measure? I want to change different measures, right? Here I'm saying item amount. I want to create by quantity. I want to see by quantity. I want to change it to quantity. So for that also, you can create a field parameter. So fields, here dynamic measures. Here one thing I want to highlight here is, like, you cannot use the implicit measures directly from the, that is implicit measure means these are the columns from the table, you cannot use that directly. You need to use explicit measures. Okay, this is sales amount, sales quantity, That's it. So dynamic measures. Let us have here, let's have a same format for this. I will have a different column for this. Let me copy and paste this one. And here, instead of dynamic dimension, let's go for a simple use case, category name. Okay. And then here, I use the dynamic measure, okay, x-axis. There you go. Now you can see here, without selecting, I use dynamic measures. So both are up here. This is quantity and sales amount. When I want only sales amount, you see sales amount by category name. When I see only sales quantity, now it is sales quantity by category name. You can see the numbers are changing, 2639. This is a quantity. And when you choose sales amount, it is the total amount, 263570. So that's a huge difference over here. So this is how you can able to dynamically create or enable your calculations. Let's try to see what happens when I use both dynamic measures here. I never tried. Let us see. It worked like a charm. You see, now parent band by quantity. I want to see parent band by quantity. Now you see parent band by sales quantity. I'm getting it in this chart. In this chart, I choose both dynamic dimension, dynamic measure. And if I want location by quantity, then I want a sales amount. All I need to do is just switch between these measures. Okay. Now I am seeing the sales amount by location. Even the headers are dynamically changing. Sales quantity by location. So you can have a simple chart, and with different dimensionality and different measures listed, then you can do your play around or self-servicing BI. This is where the real self-servicing BI comes into place, where users should have the ability to choose different dimensions and measures so that they can play around with their own data instead of predefining this templates how it should look like, right? So I hope this is what field parameters all about. I told about the problem statement, how you can dynamically switch between the dimensions and measures, right? And how you can edit it. There is no way you can edit this once you create a field parameter. Like if you see like create modeling, it will always prompt me to new fields. It is nothing but these field parameters. It is creating one calculated table. Okay, we created two field parameters, one for dynamic measures, one for dynamic dimensions. So it creates two tables with a single column, right? So here, in order to add some more values here, you can keep adding same content. Instead of this, you can take product item also. I mean, in the product, we have something like item. You can add it here. What happened? So in order to add a new item here, just go and copy and paste. Press Alt Enter. Comma here, make it as 3, then fact sales dot maybe some other columns will be available here, so I can put order name. Okay, by order name, order type I want to view. So when you click enter, you can see a new item called order name. Sorry, what happened? Yeah, name should be changed, order name. Okay, so immediately you can start analyzing by order name here, on shop or online order. So this is how you can able to edit it, your field parameters. I hope this is what you need to learn as an end user or whoever going to use. No need to dig much about how it works, how it performance efficient. Definitely it will be slightly performance wise going to hit, because it uses some calculated tables and lot of logics behind it. But if you want to use the self-servicing BI, you need to compromise on performance. I hope that won't be a big deal for most of the cases. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.